Not everything that this planet goes through is caused by us, but some of them do. Though, today we are not discussing something about that. Methane, a simple hydrocarbon consisting of one carbon atom and four hydrogen atoms, has been detected on several planets and celestial bodies within our solar system and beyond. It's also the key component of Jupiter, Neptune, and Uranus's atmosphere. Its presence contributes to the planet's colorful bands and belts also. Methane gives them the distinctive blue-green coloration. Like Jupiter, it has been a topic of great interest on Mars. NASA's Curiosity rover and the Mars Express orbiter have detected intermittent traces of methane in Martian atmosphere. Though the origin of this methane is still a subject of scientific investigation, some theories suggest it could be produced by geological processes or potentially by microbial life. Lakes and rivers of liquid methane and ethane exist on Titan's surface, making it one of the very few places in the solar system with stable liquid bodies. Well, that makes it very clear that methane is very common in our solar system, certainly more common than water. But recently, scientists have found out a sudden surge in the methane in Earth's atmosphere, which can be incredibly potent when it comes to its impact on our environment. So, hold on to your seats as we explore a sudden surge in methane levels that has scientists questioning if we are on the brink of an ice age termination phase. What does this mean for our planet? What are the implications of this alarming discovery? Prepare to be captivated by the scientific evidence and theories that will leave you with goosebumps. It's getting hot outside, isn't it? Some of it is happening due to human interventions, but some of it isn't. Today, what we have on Earth is due to heating of our planet also, because there was a time when the planet used to be covered in ice, what is also known as the Ice Age. Although a more proper scientific name for this is quaternary glaciation, something that began approximately 2.6 million years ago with the appearance of the first glacial period. In reality, this is still the Ice Age. We are still in it even today. Numerous research studies have delved into the analysis of ice cores from Antarctica, revealing a discerning cooling pattern characterized by two distinct cycles, one spanning 41,000 years and other extending over 100,000 years. This recurring pattern shows a consistent sequence of ice sheet expansion succeeded by a phase of decline. Typically, this cycle fluctuates within the range of 80,000 to 120,000 years, with an average duration of approximately 100,000 years. Examining the graph, one can discern that the most recent major glaciation period concluded approximately 12,000 years ago. However, it's still worth noticing that Earth's climate was quite likely even warmer than it is today. Roughly around 140 to perhaps 130,000 years ago, during which the volume of ice was lower compared to the present day. This last interglacial period holds particular fascination, as it is coincided with a time when various hominid species inhabited the planet. Early human ancestors, along with our cousins, such as Neanderthals and Denisovans, coexisted on a subtly different Earth during this intriguing epoch. However, the geography of the past was vastly altered. The Mediterranean landscape differed significantly with reduced water levels, and the British Isles were essentially connected to Europe. This remarkable chapter in history came to an abrupt close approximately 12,000 years ago. But what's interesting about this recent cycle is that approximately 6,000 years ago, for some reason, Earth stopped warming up and stopped melting the rest of the ice. And so, for roughly around 6,000 years, humans on Earth got lucky. We suddenly received the relatively stable climate that didn't really change very much, allowing various civilizations on the planet to suddenly explode, developing the cultures we have today. Now that's the kind of general assumption. We obviously have no idea exactly what happened, but it has always been believed that Milankovitch cycles sort of affect a lot of things, and luckily for humans, this cycle was predicted to be somewhat moderate, with the next potential glaciation happening maybe in the next 50 to 70,000 years. To illustrate this phenomenon, various sedimentary studies have revealed that sea levels underwent a remarkable increase of approximately 130 meters between 20,000 and 6,000 years, after which they noticeably stabilized. The graph provided here visually depicts the fluctuations in sea level over the past 20,000 years. What's intriguing is that throughout each of these glaciation cycles, as indicated in the graph, there is a distinct and intriguing phase known as termination. These termination phases are characterized by exceedingly abrupt temperature spikes, creating an unusual and striking pattern in the graph. Today, our understanding of termination events reveals them to be pivotal events in the reconfiguration of Earth's climate system. These terminations frequently unfolded in a series of three distinct stages. The initial stage involves an elevation in methane and carbon dioxide levels. Following this, the second stage manifests as global warming, typically spanning a few thousand years. Lastly, the third stage is marked by a rapid temperature escalation, typically driven by a surge of methane concentrations. This heightened temperature phase can persist for several thousand years, contributing to the intricate dynamics of termination events. Interestingly, termination events, despite their overall duration spanning several thousand years, often exhibit an abrupt phase that lasts only a few decades. This final stage culminates in a significant methane release, intensifying temperatures for millennia. It's during this stage that we typically witness a dramatic surge in sea levels, accompanied by extensive melting of ice across the planet. As illustrated in the graph, Earth experiences a temperature increase of up to 3 to 4 degrees Celsius during this phase. Based on sedimentary evidence, we can infer that the last occurrence of such an event transformed regions like the tundra into tropical landscapes, hosting a remarkable array of unfamiliar and exotic creatures roaming on Earth's surface. All these details makes it very clear that Earth is going to get even hotter. The findings from this new paper shed light on global methane levels and their intriguing trends. It's well documented that human emissions of methane experienced a significant surge in the 1980s, but they generally stabilized by the 1990s. This stabilization was attributed to a combination of regulatory measures and advancements in technology that allowed for more efficient methane extraction, reducing unintentional releases. However, something quite perplexing occurred in the late 2006. Methane levels began to rise dramatically once more, accelerating their growth and surpassing various emission rates. What makes this phenomenon particularly puzzling is that available data suggests human emissions either decreased or remained relatively stable during this period, with no significant shifts in human activities recorded worldwide. As a result, scientists are inclined to believe that this methane surge is not attributable to human activities. This raises the critical question: what is driving this unexpected and substantial increase in methane levels? It is unclear what is exactly the source yet. What's clear is that it's definitely growing bigger and bigger. While human activity may not be the primary driver behind the recent surge in methane levels, it's crucial to recognize that this situation has its roots in the past human actions. Even if we are not responsible for the methane surge, we must take precautionary actions because all our lives depend on it. Thanks, and if you have reached this far, then I hope I can get a like and subscribe from you. My goal was not political, but just giving data and sharing the new findings with you all. Remember to look up to the sky, as the future is space.